Hi guys, it's Ashley from Ashley's Paper Heart, and today I thought we could go over what I am taking with me as far as journaling supplies on my vacation. So hopefully you find that interesting. So this to start with, actually let's start with my main journal. So I am bringing my Hobonichi. I write in this every day, so I couldn't imagine not writing in this. And she's a little fuller than she normally is. So, what I'm bringing as far as like ephemera, I'm just using this Traveler's Company like plastic holder with the zipper pouch and stuck it in here. I usually keep this in here anyway, but I just put a few extra things in the pockets. So, normally, I keep stickers in this pocket that I want to use, and that's, even without traveling. So I just want to use some of these up. So I put them in here. Finally, using these Traveler's Company stickers. I bought these last year in hopes that we would be traveling. We did not travel. So a lot of these stickers have like the 2020 year stamped on it, so that's okay. We didn't get to travel in 2020, but we are in 2021. And then some of these dot stickers. So those will be the stickers that I'm taking with me. In here, I just have random bits of ephemera and a washi sample card. I don't really want to pull everything out. This is typically what I would keep in here anyway. I only added a few extra things. Again, this is kind of where I keep little random bits that I want to use up. I also put in a few of these washi strips that I can use. This is actually a new one that I just got from Nikoneko. It's Pion or Pion. I don't know how to pronounce it, but I'm sure someone will correct me. But yeah, I really like this. They're each of these little things are individual stickers, well, washi stickers. So this will be incredibly handy for doing that kind of stuff on the go and having a good variety. And then I also put some of these like washi stamps in here with the backing on them. So again, I have a little more options because I am notorious for overpacking, and journaling is no exception. So stuck in here, because we are going up to the mountains and there are bears and all sorts of critters up there, creatures, I did want to include these stickers. They were just too big to fit into this. And then some of these forest stickers because we will be in the forest. And then I'm finally taking one of these little sticker cards that I got from Sticky Kit. So I'm excited to use this. It'll totally be relevant. Let's see. In here, I have another washi card, and then I have some just random papers to collage with so that I can actually do a little bit of collaging. So I'm gonna put all this back. I'm filming in the middle of the day, so hopefully you can't hear like all the car noises that I'm hearing, but we do live on a busy, well, near a busy street, not exactly on a busy street. So I'm just tucking all that in, and I was really trying. This is traveling light for me, by the way, and I'm proud of myself. So now that's as far as this. My main journal, which I do plan on journaling in while I'm gone, because I can't not. And then this is actually, this is the large Superior Labor pouch. I really love this. I use this for my plein air painting kit. So when I paint just around here, I do take this with me. Typically, I don't have a traveler's notebook in here, but I have a sketchbook. I do need to go today before we leave tomorrow. to the art store here so that I can get a new small size sketchbook because I have filled my other one up and I would like to have a smaller size for painting outdoors or painting while we're there. So, anyways, I have the little Traveler's Company charm. I love the way that these little brass charms patina. So, I'm really, really excited. And I'm really excited to see this. It's just a standard Traveler's Company notebook. I believe it's in the camel color, the leather. I think eventually I want to get this modified, like through Wangkuchen. Okay, tangent. But anyway, I'm really excited to see how this patinas and scratches and stuff once, we're traveling. So I do have the craft like folder insert in here. I have two pencil boards. I don't know why I have two pencil boards in here. Probably because I didn't want to store them anywhere else. So I do have pencil boards in there. Now this has been my travel journal for I guess since 2020. Obviously, I couldn't fill it up because we didn't travel. And then I ended up doing like our little local adventures, like the different trails we would go on and stuff, or if something big happened, we visited somewhere new locally. So I've been using it for that kind of thing, as you can see. I just haven't been filling this out lately. But anyway, I do have space in here. I'm not sure if I'm going to document in here or if I'm going to do it in a separate book because I do have both in here. I have this little zipper pouch. I got it from Amazon. It was pretty cheap. It's like, it almost feels like that wax cotton, but it's got pockets, and I figured this will be great for keeping up with any ephemera that I collect while we're out. And so this is the book, the insert that I think I will be using to do any sort of documenting. I want to do some sketching in here. I want to do some writing. I really want to take time to reflect and be one with nature and kind of like get my feelings and thoughts out and ideas out on a page and just kind of like let that be its own thing. So I'm thinking about using this insert to do that. And it's just a plain insert, just with the special cover art. And of course, I will be putting a pin in here. Actually, I might have the pin that I want to put in there. I'm just using Sarasa Zebra, one of the vintage colors. I believe this is sepia. So that's what I plan on using for when we are gone, and hopefully it fits in there. So there we go. So that's closer to what it's gonna look like in my bag. So yeah. All right, now to the actual bag. And because I plan on doing watercoloring while I'm out there, I am bringing my excuse how dirty it is, my artist masking tape. I have some glue sticks in here just for when I'm journaling. I think I'll probably take it out when we're actually hiking. Usually, this is what I will just stick in my Camelback that I use when I'm hiking. So, to start, I have my everyday palette. This is my core watercolors. They're what I use most of the time. As you can see, this palette is very well loved, and I do need to clean it before we go. This is my portable painter palette, which looks like I got kind of messy. I really enjoy this one, especially if you're painting without water brushes. So it's a plastic palette. That's probably my only complaint. It's a plastic palette. It does come with this little brush. I don't use this brush very often, but I do keep it in there just in case. But yeah, these are all Daniel Smith watercolors. I have my basics, and then I have a few extra ones like I think Opera Pink and a few other colors that aren't like just the basic warm tone and cool tone primary colors. Because you can get so much out of just a small amount of colors if you have the right mixes. So, and I love this because it is like so portable. And these little things attach to the side, and they can be water cups or just a stand for your holder or your palette. So usually when I'm out, and I will of course refill all of my things. So I typically, when I'm out painting, I do water brushes just because it's easier. I do have this travel brush. It's not my favorite, I'm not gonna lie. Look how fluffy it got. It does get fluffy once it's dried. I need to put some of that brush cleaner soap in it and leave a little bit of the soap so that it can keep its shape. When it has the sizing in it, it is pretty like thin and pointed. It's just, this is the reason why I don't like it, because I have to wet it to kind of like get it back in there, or otherwise it's just going to be like a mess. But it attaches here so that you have like a full length brush. I really need to find a better travel brush. That's why I mostly stick to these. I also have my microperm. What is this? 0.5? 5? Yeah, 0.5. This is great because it's permanent. It doesn't lift with watercolor, and so you can do layers. Oops. I bring this Karataki. Wait, is this a Karataki? No, it's a Tombow. Okay, it's a Tombow little, like, thicker of a line kind of brush pen. This is my Tombow pencil. I typically sketch with mechanical pencils. I just find it easier and I like a thinner line. Of course, I have lead for my mechanical pencil. I have my the white rubber erasers. I always keep this because if you go a little crazy with watercolor, it's easier to just add a white gel pen to kind of bring back your highlights. And then I have my other, these actually are all three different size brushes. So yeah, that's why I have three of them. And is there anything else? Some more lead. And I do carry one of these like binder clips just to keep my sketchbook open, and I have a ruler, like a tiny ruler in there. So, of course, I will be bringing scissors and just like any other like general supply things that I would need to do like my everyday journaling. Yeah, that's kind of it. And for me, this is packing light. So I'm actually quite proud of myself. And like I said, I will be putting in a smaller sketchbook in here, maybe like a 5x7 or something like that. It depends on what sizes they have. And I typically, when I use watercolor sketchbooks on the go, I like Stillman Burn. I believe the Zeta or Beta, one of those. But those are my favorite watercolor books or sketchbooks to use watercolor in. So yeah, that's it. So hopefully this was helpful to someone. I know for me, I was really unsure what I was gonna pack. And so I'm pretty happy with the decisions that I've made. Like I said, I really find comfort in having my items with me, especially like my notebooks. Like just having it in hand, it feels comforting. So I'm happy to have, some notebooks that I can hold on to while we're out, and for me to document and take notes and draw and, just commune with nature. That's the whole point. So that's kind of it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful, and I will, well, subscribe, hit the like, comment, let me know what you would take or what you do take on trips, and I will see you guys later. Bye.